Previously
on Happy Town.
Welcome to Haplin, or some folks like to call it Happy Town.
The third floor is off limits. I'm not joking.
It's been a murder.
I'm not gonna believe it.
Not the magic man. He's someone you pass by on the street.
Why do they call him the magic man?
He had an ability to make people disappear that bordered on the mystical.
Chloe burned the can.
Who's Chloe?
It's me, Chloe. I'm gonna go up now.
We can't stop him. We never could.
Can we get him something for the pain?
140.
You're doing great, Pop. Just stay with me.
Still the only girl I ever loved.
Somebody get him something for the pain.
I'm drowning in a lake. You're crazy.
Get him some damn pain medication.
Listen, I need you to stand back here.
Chloe, I'm coming back for you someday.
Doc, what's wrong with him?
We'll figure that out. Is this it?
Yeah.
Good. Let's go.
Tommy, these people.
Pop.
They're wicked. And I don't mean ordinary wicked. I mean, their blood is black. And their souls are hideous. Diabolic.
Okay, Pop, it's gonna be okay. I'm gonna be right here when you get out. I'm gonna be right here when you get out, Pop. Okay, let's go. You're gonna be fine. Be right here.
I just like watching Thawfest evolve. Every year I come down early and check it out.
Well, maybe one year you could actually help.
No one doesn't like me.
Nope. Not at all.
What's wrong?
Honestly, I'm just feeling crappy about being there. At Max Pond, the night Jerry Friddle got murdered, and I never said a word about it to the sheriff or Tommy.
We've been through this. You didn't see anything. You know they're gonna ask what you were doing at Max Pond at that time of night. You can't say you were with me.
Right. Otherwise, our secret love affair is no longer a secret.
Music room, fourth period?
Meet you beneath the harpsichord. What is it? Something terrible happened to Sheriff Conroy. What happened?
Big Dave.
Lincoln.
Still using New York City tap water in your pizza now?
Of course.
You know, Sheriff Conroy, he told me you get that water shipped in twice a week all the way from New York. Is that true?
Yep.
Is it true what I heard about old Sheriff Conroy?
I don't know. He's definitely in the hospital. I'm actually going over there right now.
Okay, well, you give him my best.
Will do, Lincoln.
Unbelievable!
Griffin Conroy lopped his mitt off with a hatchet.
Oh, why would he do that?
Probably. Because he run out of things to clap for.
What's going up?
Hey, going up. Great idea!
It just didn't occur to me. I suppose it didn't occur to you either, but her warnings were so extreme.
The third floor is strictly off limits.
And I'm not joking.
I just didn't figure that it would be locked. I'm not sure, but I'm gonna hold on a sec.
Henley, we have a surprise for you.
The best surprise in the history of surprises.
Oh, more toast. You are kind, Mrs. Meadows.
My pleasure.
Close your eyes, Henley.
What is going on?
Voila! We asked Dot. She said it's all yours.
It's great. But what exactly is all mine?
The shed. To make your candles.
Oh, it's so great.
Until you find a proper space, this will be your candle workshop.
Oh. It's so great. Thank you.
I'm standing here staring at him. My father, strongest man I know, hoping he's gonna wake up and tell me just why it is he's been blabbering about some woman named Chloe. And then when he does that, yeah, maybe we can move on to the more pertinent question. Hey, Pops, would you mind telling me why you chopped your hand off with a hatchet?
Here's Pete now.
Tell me.
It's the best of a bad situation. The fusion was a success, but the ligature wasn't salvageable. So to regain mobility is going to be a process.
What about the MRI?
It came up clean, but obviously we're dealing with something. So I've called in a neuropathologist from up St. Paul. He's going to come take a look. Hopefully he gives us a better sense of what we're up against.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Truly.
No problem.
I'm going to call my mom.
You know, you can take off, Big Dave. We got it.
No, I told Molly to mind the shop for today. I'm here for you, TC, for the long haul.
Thanks, pal.
I gotta tell you, though, part of me feels responsible. I mean, I saw him right before he... I didn't notice anything off.
He didn't mention the name Chloe to you by any chance, did he?
I don't think so. Who's Chloe?
Tommy.
Hey, John, how you doing?
My mother would like to see you.
Now? I appreciate her reaching out, John, but my father just got off the operating table, so...
Which is 3 hours, right? Till he wakes from sedation. We'll have you right back at his side by then, and he'll never even know you left.
Call me if anything changes.
Where are you going?
To Weeping Wall.
I'd like to get these here on the top.
Casablanca. Excellent choice. You know, I do believe Casablanca holds the record for the most quotable lines in the history of cinema. Gone with the Wind has, frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn. Wizard of Oz told you I don't think we're in Kansas anymore, and there's no place like home. But Casablanca, well, here's looking at you, kid.
We'll always have Paris.
The Germans wore gray, you wore blue.
Round up the usual suspects.
Of all the gin joints in all the towns in all the world, she walks into mine.
Louis, I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Indeed.
Oh,
Deputy Conroy.
Mrs. Haplin.
Let me get a look at you. You are your mother's son, aren't you?
That's what people tell me.
It's high praise. She had a strong composition and was one of the very best we ever had at Weeping Wall.
She loved working here. She always came home with a smile.
Her facility with perennials was uncanny. The gardens here have never been the same since we lost her. Now this with your father. It's heartbreaking.
Yes, ma'am. It's unexpected.
And ill-timed. You're the incident on the pond. I had this made for my granddaughter. It was finished 2 days after she was gone. So now the neighborhood children use it. Walk with me. Good work your father has done for the county, for me, during his tenure. It's needed now more than ever.
Roger Hobbs is a pretty capable guy. He was a cop in the Twin Cities before he moved to Haplin.
Roger Hobbs mooches the stem. He doesn't have leadership qualities. He lacks authority. Which is why, until Griffin gets his right back, I would like you to step in as acting sheriff of Haplin County.
Me?
I'm affecting you as of this discussion.
With all due respect, Mrs. Haplin, I'm just a four-year deputy, and I'm certainly not my father. You know, we have a chain of command. Hobbs is chief inspector.
Roger Hobbs mooches the stem.
Mrs. Haplin, I don't know what that means.
It means I think you'll be great.
What about John? But your son's not a fan of my father. I don't see him sitting easy with another Conroy being perched.
My son is an obsessive. And though I share his agony over the disappearance of our Abby, his choice to fixate on the magic man has not only hurt the spirit of this community, it has rendered him an irrelevance. So I would suggest you do what your daddy did and remind yourself just whose founding capital pays for the apricots in your little girl's lunch pail. Good luck, Sheriff.
Our only clue is we've not been able to rustle up any eyewitnesses, although we've canvassed practically the whole town, is a powder that was found on the victim. It appears to be some type of bacon flour. It's been sent off to the state lab for further analysis.
How's Griff, TC?
Yeah, he's resting.
What's the next move on the Friddle case? Sheriff?
Business as usual. You're still running lead on the case. You call the shots.
All right, let's get to work.
I stepped in three damn puddles on my way home. Not one, not two, three. Shoes are ruined. Ruined. I need to go and change my socks before I die of pneumonia.
What?
Mrs. Meadows.
Mr. Grieves.
I do believe it's time for the pre-supper foxtrot. Won't you join me?
Midnight
and the stars with you. Midnight and a rendezvous. Thank you, Mrs. Meadows. There's nothing like a little knocking of the knees to aid the digestion. Shall we go into the kitchen and unwrap your parcels? Hello, Henley.
Hello.
I'll be right back. Hey, Tom, how's the sheriff?
He's gonna be fine.
That's rocking good news.
Yeah.
Hey, you be sure to let him know that if he ever needs a hand.
Tom.
Well, hello, Mrs. Haplin. John.
Hello. We're just about to get underway.
Yeah, I just wanted to say, after giving it a lot of thought, I have to decline your offer. I just really think it'll be best for everybody if Roger Hobbs is made sheriff.
Okay.
Okay?
I'm sorry you feel that way. Understand. We must not let rumors get out of control and take on a life of their own. Yes, Sheriff Griffin Conroy has taken ill. He's under observation, but I promise that as soon as we know more, we will pass it along. In the meantime, let's keep Griffin and his family in our prayers. I know what is on everyone's mind. The timing of this is dreadful. What with the incident on the pond? Which is why I am so pleased to announce the appointment of a new acting sheriff. Please help me to introduce and welcome our new sheriff, Tommy Conroy.
Thank you, Mrs. Haplin. Thank you. With regards to the incident, the pond, as Mrs. Haplin referred to it, now would be a good time for an old salt to scratch his nails across the chalkboard and claim that he can catch the head, the tail, and the whole damn fish. It's a Jaws reference.
Maybe you ought to reference the Daffy Duck cartoon, where Daffy becomes the sheriff of a one-horse town and ends up as janitor, Porky Big says.
Lucky for him, it is a one-horse town.
Thank you.
Can I borrow your creamer?
Of course. You got someone upstairs?
Yeah, sadly.
Friend or family?
Family. Kinda. Grandpa never had sort of thing.
Yeah. Is he gonna be all right?
No one can say. How about you? Who are you here for?
No one. I come for the tapioca. Sam, a firm believer that all of society's ills could be quelled if everybody just had a little pudding.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Hmm?
Well, so long.
Your sort of grandpa will be in my thoughts.
And your tapioca will be in mine.
It's just first day jitters, TC. It happens to everyone.
He's right. My first day at the ready, I was a mess.
First day I opened this place, it was a total basket case.
Yeah. Great, you guys. Except neither one of those things involves solving a murder. I totally froze up there.
It's no big deal, TC. Yeah. It's like junior year. Remember when Coach Friddle left? You had to give that giant speech in front of the entire school because you were the quarterback.
Exactly. And if you remember, I froze then too.
Yeah, you did.
Except you bailed me out with that poem you made up right on the spot.
Like, the point is, TC, after that, nobody doubted your ability to march us up the field.
And nobody's gonna doubt you now. Shame you're gonna miss the Thaw Fest. I know how much you love it. I'm hoping that my dad doesn't show up. Remember what happened last year? Get better soon, huh? You're the only one who I can do the Sunday crossword puzzle with in ink.
In my younger days, I felt sorry for myself that I had no gloves. Until I met a man with no hands.
Hello?
It's a French thing, all right? It's a dance. This guy,
watching himself in the mirror, and he's dancing. You understand?
Okay.
I don't know why you always do this.
Shut up!
He always does this. Stupid.
Listen.
Listen to me.
Watch yourself go.
Go by.
Go by. Go
by.
Waking up.
Oh, good.
Hi. Oh.
What am I doing here?
Oh, baby boy wants to say hi.
Baby boy, where are you going? Why are you always scaring him away?
Hello, Georgia. Are you okay? Do you want some tapioca?
Part of me? I tell you, Pop, part of me thinks all Peggy Haplin wants is a puppet. I mean, not that you were a puppet, but you did insist on letting sleeping dogs lie, which is what Mrs. Haplin wants. With me, I figure she's of the mind that even if I wanted to wake up those sleeping dogs, I'd be too much of a nincompoop to do it. Well, I don't know, Pop. She's probably right.
He'll be back.
Pop?
Now that blood's been spilled again, he'll be back.
What? Who?
The serpent always hisses where the sweet bird sings, Chloe.
Pop? Pop, who's Chloe? Pop, talk to me. Who's Chloe? Pop. Talk to me. Who the hell is Chloe? Yeah.
You need to come home right now.
I ran and ran and ran.
Did they hurt you?
Her eyes were dilated when she got here. The stiletus must have drugged her.
No, that doesn't make sense. I had a cup of coffee.
Did they hurt you?
I don't know.
Georgia, did they hurt you?
I don't know.
I got your message, boss. They're in the barn. What? We're making an arrest?
Not an arrest, Root Beer.
Conroy, what the hell are you doing? You want some pipe, huh? You want some of this, yeah?
You drugged her, huh?
Oh, no, man. The Brown girl, no. Look, we found her on the living room floor, all right?
You're lying.
No,
Tommy.
I swear, please.
What is it, Root Beer? I'm kind of in the middle of something.
It's the state lab. The guy says it's urgent.
Yeah, hello?
Oh, hey there.
This is Murtaugh at the state lab. Yeah, we got the organics back on the substance covering your homicide victim.
Jerry Friddle?
Yeah, this really isn't a good time.
It's definitely flour.
But it didn't come from your factory. Now, I know that because we also found some traces of dough.
Yeah, it's a special kind that contains...
Get this. A fluoride found only in New York City tap water.
It was mixed into the dough. What do you make of that? Maybe your guy got gooned by a pastry chef on vacation from Coney Island?
What's up, Tizzy?
It's like the man says. Serpent always hisses where the sweet bird sings.
Tommy.
Hey, Mrs. D. Is he around?
No. I expect him soon for supper, though.
Oh, no worries. I was just gonna grab my drill gun, but I can come back.
Don't be silly. It's in the basement. You know the way.
No idea.
What are you gonna do, TC? Pull your gun on me?
What do you want me to do, Dave? Thank you?
In a way.
You hammered a railroad spike into Jerry Friddle's skull.
Yeah, I thought it was pretty clever.
A railroad spike. Sent us straight to the Stivaletto's, huh? Because everybody knows the Stivaletto's hated Friddle. And God knows they got plenty of spikes laying around their place.
Well. They do live by the tracks. Come on, man. I did it. I killed the magic man.
Friddle was not the magic man.
Of course he was. I've been working on this for years, TC. Surveilling, gathering evidence, making my case.
Making your case? Who the hell are you to make your case? You make pizzas, Dave.
I got rock solid evidence.
You got nothing.
Things were overlooked.
They weren't.
Man, those people, all those missing people.
My father investigated all of this when all that skulking trouble went down. And Jerry Friddle was in Las Vegas for a family reunion when Billy Mixon disappeared. No. And he was in the hospital with gallstones when Lauren Ward vanished. But you stupid, fat moron. You just killed an innocent man based on half-baked conclusions after doing some junior varsity detective work? Who the hell are you? Who the hell are you to even get involved?
Well, nobody else was doing anything. Man, Griff wanted everybody just to forget about it.
Griff wanted the town to heal, Dave.
Well, you can't heal a wound, Tommy, until you clean it out.
Everything okay down there?
Yeah, Mom, me and Tommy's just having a gab.
Tom, wanna stay for dinner?
I'm fine, Mrs. D.
No, Ma, he's okay.
All right, Dave. Supposing you're right. Supposing Jerry Friddle was the magic man. Then you just killed the only person that can tell us what happened to those people.
He told me where the bodies are.
What?
Mm-hmm.
Friddle told you where the bodies were.
Yeah.
Did you have a gun pointed at his head when he told you this?
Yeah. So?
You ever think maybe he was under duress?
that maybe you would say anything to get his ass out of that shack?
It wasn't like that. It wasn't like that.
You stupid, pathetic idiot.
He was taking them!
He was taking nothing! You've been my best friend since third grade, Dave. And today I find out you're a killer? Who's got a lair? What are we supposed to do now, Dave? Huh? What am I supposed to do now?
You do your job. You caught me. So we tell everyone what I did and why I did it.
No. No, we don't, Big Dave. Because if we do, you go to jail forever. All right? Because Jerry Friddle was not the magic man. You hear me? Jerry Friddle was not the magic man!
He told me where the bodies are!
Oh, Dave, we gotta figure something out. We gotta figure something out soon.
So I'm going now to buy the car. Yeah, I found a used car place a couple towns over. Right. Well, the point being, once I reveal myself, you know, I get the heck out of Dodge. Yeah.
What is this?
Nothing.
Georgia.
It's nothing, Andrew.
Did your father do this?
No.
Georgia, did your father do this?
He didn't.
I'm gonna kill him. I swear.
Actually, I visited Sheriff Conroy in the hospital. And I got drugged or something, and I ended up at the Stivaletto's place. And somewhere along the way, I hit my face.
Yeah, nice try. I'm gonna kill your old man. I swear to God, Georgia, I'm gonna kill your old man.
Andrew.
Thank you.
Cap Conroy. Dan Farmer, State Police. I work with Captain Frost, and I'm here to help.
You work with Captain Frost, huh?
I do, and I'm here to help.
I'm surprised Frost hasn't paid us a visit himself. You know, back in the days, a real presence.